If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, and the light around me become night, even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is as bright as the day, for darkness is as light to you. We hear these words of the psalmist and we take comfort in them. We welcome you tonight to this blue Christmas service, a time when we can acknowledge the sadness and hopelessness and grief that we feel. This is the time where we have the shortest day and the longest night, when memories of past experiences and the pain of our present reality can be overwhelming. We recognize that this is not a season of great joy for everyone. In this service, we invite you to join us as we reflect on the pain, the loneliness, and the sorrow we may feel, and we offer it to our great source of hope, the Holy Child born in Bethlehem. Let us pray. Gracious, loving, merciful God, we come to you tonight feeling alone, feeling hopeless, feeling a need to rest in your arms, feeling a need for healing and comfort. God of hope, we come to you tonight. Amen.
We mourn this on this night, the loss of life. We light this Advent candle to remember those persons whom we have loved and lost. We pause to remember their names, their faces, their voices. For so many, the pandemic has taken loved ones. We mourn the loss of those close to us and those whose names we do not know. We mourn those who perished while working to save our lives. We mourn those who died, not of pandemic, but of other causes. We mourn the loss of those whose lives were lost to brutality and violence. We mourn the loss, in many cases, of our ability to be with them as they passed. Our loss of gathering together for comfort in the ways we need it so much. And we give thanks for the memory that binds them with us this season, which anticipates Christmas.
We mourn on this night of loss. We light the second candle to redeem the pain of loss, the loss of relationships, the loss of jobs, the loss of health. Light the second. For so many, the pandemic has taken the security of food and shelter, care for families, and medical care. We mourn the loss of the businesses that could not withstand the circumstances. These were not just businesses, but dreams born of passion and hard work. We mourn those who find themselves needing to rely on others for help, when what they really want to do is to be able to help others. As we gather up the pain of loss, we offer it to you, O God, asking that into our open hands you place the gift of peace.
We mourn this night the loss of love. We mourn the division we are experiencing as a nation. We mourn the hate, suffering, oppression, and the injustice that is present today. We mourn the loss of our ability to love one another despite our differences. As human beings who deserve to be seen for our inherited beauty and worth.
We pause and remember the past weeks, months, and for some of us, years of difficult times. We mourn this night of loss of life within us. We light the fourth candle to remember the poignancy of memories, the grief, the sadness, the hurts, the pain of reflecting on our own mortality. For so many, this year has robbed us of our energy, our enthusiasm, and our sense of well-being. We mourn teachers and leaders, caregivers, workers who are struggling to help those in their care, themselves exhausted and needing help, the sustenance that they give to others. We mourn with all who are suffering with anxiety and depression, who are finding it difficult to live each day with the fullness or to find hope for tomorrow. We mourn those we have lost to suicide. We mourn those who find themselves addicted to substances in order to ease pain that feels unbearable. We mourn those who are experiencing their homes as an abusive place from which they struggle to escape.
And now we light the fifth candle, just as we will do later this week on Christmas Eve. We light this as a sign of our belief. We believe in the light that has come and is coming. This light casts its glow on all the surrounding prayers we have prayed. This light resides within us, perhaps dim for a time, but always lit, an amber of the holy inside of us.
For a miracle, the heart longs for a little bit of hope. Oh, come, Emmanuel. A child prays for peace on earth, and she's calling out from a sea of hurt. Oh, come, Emmanuel. With the tears of a mother, a baby's cry is the sound of love. Come down, come down, Emmanuel. He is the song for the suffering. He is Messiah, the Prince of Peace. Has come, he has come, Emmanuel. The world, glory. a little bit of hope. Oh, come, Emmanuel.
Please turn in your Bibles to the Old Testament book of Isaiah, chapter 9, beginning with verse 2. Hear these prophetic words from the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Turn in your Bibles to the Gospel of Luke in the New Testament. Our reading begins in chapter 2 with verse 8. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child laying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had seen and heard, as it had been told them. The word of God for the people of God.
As we gather together this evening, I know that many of us are in circumstances and places of great grief. We have experienced great loss, deep loss, this year. I too experienced a great loss in January of this year. Many of us have experienced deep loss throughout the years, and really there are no words that I can say tonight to make it all better. There are no words I can give you to make the hurt stop hurting, but we can take great comfort in knowing that Jesus experienced all these same kinds of feelings. Jesus experienced grief. Jesus wept, just as we weep for those we love and have lost. What I can offer you tonight is a bit of light in the darkness. In the darkness of grief, I can offer hope. Hope in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Our hope lies in Jesus, the baby who came to save his people from their sins. The good news of great joy is that God loves us so much that he gave his only son so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life. Paul tells us in his letter to the churches in Rome, "For in hope we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope. For who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience." With hope, we are invited to view our circumstances through the eyes of faith, trusting that God is at work and that God will never leave us or abandon us. Echoing Paul's prayer for the church at Ephesus, I pray for you today that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you. What are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe according to the working of his great power. I invite you now to a time of quiet reflection as we offer this musical offering.
Shepherds rise. close my eyes to see the night when love was born. A perfect child gently waits, a mother bends to kiss God's face. I close my eyes to see the night when love was born. Angels fill the midnight sky and they sing, hallelujah, He is Christ our King.
A time of where we give ourselves to God. We place it all at the feet of our Holy Savior. And we can respond by giving offerings to God's ministry and mission that can be done through electronically or it can be done through mail. But it's more than our tithes and offerings, folks. It's about giving our hearts, our whole beings. We've heard about love being born. We are loved by God, and we are called to give of ourselves lovingly to each other and to God.
See our King, for He is the
Gift, the gift given to us, unearned, unmerited, the great gift given to us by our Creator God. We now move in to a time of where we put our prayers before God. So in the spirit of this season, let us now ask our God for what we need for ourselves as we participate in the Christmas season. As people are coping with loss, pain, suffering, loneliness, grief, sadness, the list goes on. Let us pray. God, we come to you as Christmas dawns with pain growing inside of us. As the nights have been growing longer, so has the darkness wrapped itself around our hearts. In this season of our longest nights, we offer to you the pain in our hearts. The traumas that some of us cannot even put into words. Compassionate God, there are those among us who are grieving over what might have been. A death or loss has changed our experience of Christmas. Once it was a special day for us too, but someone has died or moved away. Or we've lost a job, or we've lost a dream. We find ourselves adrift, alone, lost. Lord, help us find our way. The Christmas season reminds us that all of us can be used, of what can be used and what cannot be anymore. The memories of what was, the fears of what may be overwhelm us. All around us we hear the sounds of celebration, but all we experience is a sense of feeling blue. Please be near us. Please wrap us in your arms, O God. We invite you to offer your own prayers and thanksgivings. Silently at this time. Loving God, hear our prayers this night. Grant to all, and especially those in sorrow this Christmas, the blessing we ask in the name of Christ, who taught us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May the light of Christ shine through our deepest darkness and sustain us on our journey with faith, hope, and love. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. We wish you a blessed Christmas time where you feel God's loving arms wrapped around you and his peace with us always. Amen.